Hi friends, in this video we will try to derive a mathematical expression for continuous time Fourier series, CTFS, the exponential form of CTFS. Let us think that x of t is a linear combination of three complex exponentials. And we can write x of t as a1 e power s1t plus a2 e power s2t plus a3 e power s3t, where s1 e power s1t, e power s2t, e power s3t are the three complex exponentials, and a1, a2, a3 are three coefficients of the complex exponentials. From eigen function property, which we have already derived in the previous video, the response to each input, that is, if you are giving the complex exponentials separately into the LTA system, we will get the response as shown below. That is, the complex exponential a1 e power s1t will give a1 h of s e power s1t, and the complex exponential a2 e power s2t will give a2 h of s e power s2t, and the complex exponential a3 e power s3t will give a3 h of s e power s3t. The superposition principle of LTA system says that if you are giving the individual inputs, you will get the output like this. If you are adding the inputs, you will get output as a sum of these responses. So we can write y of t is equal to a1 h of s e power s1t plus a2 h of s, that is s1, this is s2. Here also we have to write that this is s1, this is s2, and this is s3. E power s2t plus a3 into h of s3 e power s3t. So we can generalize like this. If x of t is a linear combination of complex exponential, so ak is the coefficient of the complex exponential, then y of t will be the linear combination of the responses of the LTA system to the complex exponential. So we can write h of sk into e power skt. So that is, if x of t is a linear combination of complex exponential as shown here, the output will be the linear combination of the responses of the individual complex exponentials. In other words, if the input to an LTA system is represented as a linear combination of complex exponentials, then the output can also be expressed as a linear combination of the same complex exponentials. We reach at an important conclusion that Fourier series representation of continuous time periodic signals shows that any continuous time periodic signal can be expressed as a linear combination of harmonically related complex exponentials. Now consider a continuous time periodic signal x of t is equal to x of t plus t. So this is the expression for the periodic signal, that is, the same signal is repeating after the fundamental period for all t, where t is the fundamental period and omega 0 is equal to 2 pi by t is the fundamental frequency of the signal. From the above discussion, the signal x of t can be expressed thus: x of t is equal to summation k equal to minus infinity to plus infinity a k e power j k omega 0 t. It is equal to summation k is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity a k e power j k 2 pi by t into small letter t. This is an important equation, that this is the expression for continuous time Fourier series. So you can see that the essential idea is that any signal x of t can be expressed as a linear combination. So this is summation of the signal. So linear combination of complex exponential. So where ak is the coefficient or the amplification factor of this exponential. When k is 0, when k is equal to 0, you can see that the equation is a constant. So the equation is a constant and it represents the constant in the signal. So when k is equal to 1, then we can see that the equation represents first harmonic of the signal. Through this expression we know that the signal x of t is made up of lot of complex exponentials. So when k is 1, we will get the first harmonics of x of t, and when k is 2, we will get the second harmonic, and so on. It will be continuing. The above representation of the signal is known as the Fourier series representation of a signal in exponential form. We will write the equation again. X of t is equal to summation k is equal to minus infinity to plus infinity ak e power j k omega 0 t. So this representation is known as the Fourier series representation of the signal in exponential form. And this equation is also known as the synthesis equation of the continuous time Fourier series. So in this video we have derived an equation for the continuous time Fourier series case. So now we have one problem. The problem is that we have expressed the signal in terms of complex exponential e power jk omega 0 t, but the problem is, what is this coefficients ak? How to find out the coefficients ak? So that we will see in the next video. Please watch that video, then only we can say that the derivation is complete. So how to derive an expression for ak, the coefficients of the complex exponential, that we will see in the next video. Thank you for watching.